Jack, what were some of the things Matt was telling us that every player got two or three things to look at, work on? What were some of the things that coaches want you to look at during the bye?
Yeah, just little stuff with run fits, tackling lower. I know you mentioned that, and a couple more things. And you know, I think that's what the game's about, is about improving. So anyway, you can improve a little bit, especially in a bye week. Got to do that to go into the next week.
The season has been a whirlwind for you. Were you able to kind of decompress during the bye week and reflect a little bit?
Definitely nice to get away. I think it's needed. Long season. I think a lot of guys just kind of need to get away. But at the same time, you're going constantly for so many weeks, so long, that when you have that time away, it's kind of like it's a little awkward at first. And then so you kind of get that almost like that feeling, that itch to like get back into things, get back into it. Yeah.
Gordon are both coming back from concussions. What are your thoughts on that? And also, what kind of a bond have you guys all formed as rookies this year, especially on defense?
I'm excited that they can get back and go out there and make some plays. And yeah, we obviously have a pretty big rookie class, and so a lot of times, I mean, we are together, especially on this Monday. We're together for a little bit after this, and yeah, I mean, we kind of all just came in together, all with a goal to get better and help this team, and a lot of guys are still around, and you know, I'd say we're pretty close.
Okay. So much of this season has been, the talk has been about the future of this team and even next year. Do you think that you have or are in the process of earning a permanent spot at linebacker for the Bears?
I got no idea. Right now I'm focused on this week, and right now you know, my job is to play linebacker this week against the Eagles, and that's what I'm focused on.
Do you think you were going to be in this position this year?
I don't know. You know, I came in with the mindset of doing anything I can for the team, and it just so happened that now this is my job, and I'm going to try to do it to the best of my ability.
What's the challenge of Jalen Hurts as a runner?
He's super athletic, and I mean, he can improvise kind of on the run, go off script, similar to Justin. And so definitely going to be a challenge. Definitely they have a lot of different designed runs to help him get involved in the run game. So it's going to be everybody focused on their keys, knowing their rules, and playing good football.
I know the ones don't necessarily practice against the ones during the season here, but is there anything you've learned in watching Justin that helps you defend other –
got to get guys to the ball. You know, guys got to hustle and get as many hats to the ball as you can.
Jake, of all the things you've done this year, what are you most proud of? Whether it's a play, a game, just getting here, whatever. What do you feel best about, given you know where you started?
I think just being a good teammate, and I'm trying to be the best teammate for everyone here, everyone in that room, all the players that are there, and I think that's kind of thing I'm most proud of, and just continuing to do that.
Did you learn that just by being with others, or how do you, you know, I mean, how, you know, like you play with like Roquan and stuff like that. How much did you get from, you know, some of the guys who have been here and just learn, you know, how to lead, how to be a good teammate, that kind of thing, how to be an NFL player?
Yeah, I think you learn it every single day, kind of as the season goes on. I mean, I'm new to this long of a season, and kind of what the NFL. Everything about the NFL, it's my first year in it, and so I'm learning from guys all the time about, you know, how to go about it so many weeks into the season. You know, what do you do for your body? You know, how do you continue to get better, continue to help your body? And so I think this is a chance for me to always learn, always improve.
Oh, go ahead.
Coach was just mentioning ball production and taking the ball away. You mentioned it about the whole team, but he mentioned you specifically as well.
Any times this season that you can think back and say you kind of didn't take advantage of an opportunity to take the ball? So how do you go about seizing those opportunities?
Yeah, I think so. And I think, one of them is really just kind of punching the ball, forcing fumbles. I think that's something that, you know, we preach it and we do it all so much in practice. And, you know, I think it does translate to the game. I'm talking about me specifically. It does translate to the game, but at the same time, I think there are a couple times where, you know, an extra punch here and there, you know, maybe could jar that ball loose, and that's enough to change the game.
Can you do both of those things in terms of work? We talk about working on your tackling to and trying to get lower? Can you be trying to
think about both of those things, get the ball out and secure the tackle? Is that a little bit of a conflict?
We'll see.
Jack, do you think you would have been this successful no matter where you had gone, or are there factors about the spot that you picked, being here, being with this coaching staff, teammates, whatever it is, that have really you having a good rookie season?
I don't know. I think that's a pretty tough question. I mean, just because no matter where you go, no matter where you're at, everything about the situation, the environment, the people in the building, everything's different. And but I'm happy I'm here.
What has worked to your advantage in this situation? Besides your own, what you've brought to the table, what has been helpful to you or what has contributed to your success?
I think just coming in every day, being available and working to get better, working to improve, and wanting to help this team get better.
Besides, that's what you bring to the table. Besides what you have, like, what are the factors here that are part of this coaching staff or this building or organization that have been beneficial to you?
Yeah, I think what they preach, and I mean preach hard work, playing smart football, doing your job, and doing it to the best of your ability, and that's kind of what I come in every day and try to do.
Yeah, how difficult has it been to insulate yourself from all the outside stuff, especially when you're from here? I think you mentioned earlier in the week about getting out of a text chain or something like that. You know, obviously a lot of talk, you've done well. How important is it, or how much have you been able to insulate yourself from outside things, you know, that might affect you?
I mean, it's a little it's a little tough just because I'm from here, but at the same time, I think I've kind of handled it pretty well. Hasn't really been a problem. I'm kind of focused on myself, and that's where I think my focus needs to be, myself and on this team. So, I don't know. People outside don't really it doesn't really bother me.
But a lot of it's all good. Do you hear any of the talk, or you mean?
Oh well, that's good if it's all good.
Jack, real quickly, at the TV broadcast that caught you talking to Aaron Rodgers right before the 2-minute warning, do you know what? Remember what that conversation was about?
Yeah, a lot of people brought that up. I don't remember us really talking like that. I mean, he gave me the W for Wisconsin, and then kind of just, I don't know, I don't even know what I said, if I said anything, but that little bit, and maybe that's what people saw. But other than that, I don't remember us really exchanging words super a lot.
Jack, what do you want to accomplish over the last 4 weeks of the season?
I'm sorry, what?
What do you want to accomplish over the last 4 weeks of the season?
Personally, I mean, I just want to continue to get better, continue to kind of do my job and do it at a really high level. And I think a lot of things can go into that. A lot of things can show that. But that's kind of what I'm focused on. And then getting a win, you know, helping this team win games. And you know, that's what I'm here for. And that's what I want to do.
What would it mean to have good showings against, I mean, two Super Bowl contenders really coming up, Eagles, Bills? What would it mean to, like, really compete against, you know, teams of that caliber?
You know, I don't really think it's even, you know, obviously the Eagles, and then I think you're talking about the Bills, two really good teams that we have coming up, but I don't think it matters as much as to them as it is just to us and us playing good football, us closing out a game, and us getting that win.
Thank you.
Sam, what was on your kind of bi-week self-scouting to-do list?
Pass set efficiency, working on that, cleaning that up. And then, you know, self-scouting myself throughout the game to see the things I want to work on. A few of the other things I don't want to give tells away to defenders. But, yeah, the main thing for me was pass set efficiency, just making sure it was smooth in my sets and then, you know, starting the fight.
How did you balance
kind of studying that but also getting away from the game a little bit?
Yeah, I don't know. I didn't really get away. I was really immersed in it. I mean, we have 4 weeks left to go, so yeah, we're gonna have plenty of time this offseason to get away from the game. I try to dedicate all my time in season to, you know, getting better and helping the Bears win football games. So, it's fine for me. You know, I guess, you know, a little bit of time away from the facility was nice, just being able to hang out with the family. But yeah, you know, I've studied up on myself, watched, you know, previous games that I played, watched other teams around the league. It was cool to sit down and watch football on Sunday. That was pretty cool. My father-in-law let me use his NFL Sunday ticket, so I was able to watch as much football as I wanted to. So that was cool.
Sam, do you think that there is a higher level that the offense can still get to this year, like in terms of making big strides?
For sure. I mean, anytime you're 3-10, you can, you know, sit back and say we can execute better in certain situations and give ourselves a chance to win games. And that's something Coach Fluce has preached to us, the ability to finish games. And I feel like that's where we can get better as an offense for sure. The defense has done a great job at the end of the games, giving us a chance to go down and score points to put the game away. And we haven't done that as well as we should have.
What do you think the difference has been in not being able to close out games?
I don't know. It's tough. But, I mean, this is the NFL. We're a young offense, a young group. You have to learn how to win football games. There's a lot of veteran teams, a lot of around the league, and you can kind of see it. Like they know how to win. They know what it takes. And not that we don't know what it takes to win. We know what it takes, but it's all 11 guys being on the same exact page, not shooting ourselves in the foot, getting behind the chains, getting behind the sticks on first down. And when you have one fall off here or there as an offense, I mean, it makes it hard to go down the field.
Justin's starting center for the majority of his career so far. What in what ways have you seen the most growth from him? Like beyond the spectacular runs and things like that we can see. What like behind the scenes? What have you seen from him that defines growth?
Yeah, communication. He's made a huge jump there. Just his ability to clearly communicate what he wants, getting guys lined up on the same page, making audibles at the line of scrimmage. So I think that's huge for a quarterback. I mean, I played with a few while I was here. But, there's plays and times in the game where he'll see a late rotation or something and get us to our proper check, our proper read, or if we're in a run play. This is a look we've scouted all week. He gets everybody on the same page, gets the audible in, gives me time to, you know, change up the point, and then we're rolling. Like when you're able to do that as an offense, I mean, it gives you advantageous looks to run to versus, you know, running to an 8-man box and the safety is rotating down late. Maybe we should get out of this. I don't have to worry about that. I know he's going to get us on the right thing.
Sam, your head coach was very complimentary of the pass protection from the Green Bay game.
Yeah.
Why was it better? What clicked that game for the offensive line?
We focused on it a little bit more. It's something that, you know, we knew we had to get better in across the board, really. And there were still ones that we could have had back. I know they were giving us a lot of zone coverage on the back end, too. Anytime you know you get 4-man rushes, you definitely want to execute those 4-man rushes. Where we got to clean up is the 5-man rushes, and being able to pass off games on the interior with the guards, and then on the man side, slide side, just understanding that, you know, hey, if I'm on the man side, I got to be able to set tight, snap it off, those type of things.
So the Eagles have really added to their defensive line. What's the challenge of facing that unit in particular?
I mean, it's the deepest unit in the NFL for sure in terms of talent and then in terms of experience. Like I alluded to earlier, it's a team that knows how to win football games. There's a lot of veteran presence on that side of the ball. But, I mean, the front seven, I mean, really the back end. We want to talk about the whole defense is super talented. But when you watch them play, they also understand leverage. They understand angles. They understand where the linebackers are going to fit and how it affects the technique that they are able to play. So there's times where they take shots and it doesn't necessarily make sense in what you would think the scheme is going to happen. So, I mean, they're super talented and they have a great understanding and awareness of, you know, how plays fit. Like, you know, just last night watching how Sue was fitting a double team, I'm like, how does he know that's coming? Well, he's seen it, you know, thousands and thousands of times throughout his career. So anytime you have a veteran presence like that, that's definitely a unique challenge.
How far this offense has come this year?
For sure. Anytime you work the way we work and you train the way we train, these are the tests that you want. This is what you do all that training for. I mean, you don't want to go in and, you know, face an easy challenge. You want to see what you're made of. You know, we've been hearing, you know, the offense is doing this, the offense is doing that. This is a great challenge for us, we're looking forward to it.
What stood out to you about the way Bryston Jones has handled the opportunity he's been given this year?
He's done a very good job, understand his routine and the week-to-week grind of the NFL. We had talked about it a few weeks back. Like, he would have been done playing college football already. So it's just understanding what he has to do, but the way he carries himself day in and day out, getting in the building, getting the extra stuff he needs, progressing the way that he needs to progress, is very impressive for not only a young guy, but a young guy from a small school. His understanding and awareness of what it takes to get better in the NFL and his daily pursuit of that is really cool to watch.
Seems like you were benched for like 10 snaps or whatever it was. Are you better now than you were then? Did that moment have any impact on you as far as altering your arc or whatever, or was it just seamless?
Yeah, for sure. You got to sit back and honestly evaluate yourself. And it's a continuous evaluation. That's what the NFL is. If you're not getting better, you're getting worse. Like, nobody stays in the same in this league. So I look back that mini bye we had, that Washington week, I looked back and, you know, where are the games I struggled in? Where are the areas that I struggled in? And it was pass protection. That was an easy thing to find. I went back to the Giants game, watched my pass sets against Dexter Lawrence, who's, you'd be hard-pressed to find a lot of guys in the NFL blocking him one-on-one nowadays. But, you know, that's the challenge I want. Like I alluded to earlier, I want to play teams like the Philadelphia Eagles front seven. You know, I want to play the Kenny Clarks of the NFL. I want to play the Dexter Lawrences of the NFL because that's what I train for. So I went back and watched that. I was like, all right, if I am who I say I am, I got to be able to block guys like that one-on-one so we can get other double teams where we need other help at. So that was really the game for me that I evaluated the most. And, you know, I went back, tried to clean up everything as best I could, and then as the season progresses, just continue to do things like that.
Much as it hurt at the time, do you appreciate you like had the value of being benched without being benched because you got the message?
Yeah.
But you still ended up playing.
Yeah.
How important was it to get that message?
Oh, for sure. You know, anytime you go to the bench, you have to come. You should probably come back better. So, yeah, it was. I mean, it was rough, tough pill to swallow. But at the end of the day, it was. I could talk about it or do something about it, and I chose to do something about it.
Along those lines,
Simo's best attributes as a coach.
Consistency. The message is the same every single day. And then the way he puts us in advantageous positions to make blocks. I mean, you know, I don't know the exact statistic. I know we run the football well. And a lot of that has to do with the message that we're receiving in our room every single day. And then the fact that our coaches have done a great job scheming us up and getting great looks. And the things that he tells us during the week that are going to happen, the tips that he gives us during the week, they most of them come to fruition on game day.
As a group in an offense, you guys talk about getting 3,000 yards rushing this season?
No, it hasn't come up. Obviously, first and foremost, what you want to do is win football games, and we haven't done that. So we've really focused on the areas that we have to clean up, one of those areas being pass protection and being more efficient in our passing game. You know, we just sit here and hang our hat on what we do as a strength. I mean, you know, we'll all be out of a job. So it's really been the focus on what we need to improve and how we can improve it.